A slightly nervy end to what was a fantastic performance for Wolverstone here at the Vale, a 2-1 victory against Maidstone United. I'm delighted to be joined by Wolverstone manager Dean Brennan. Dean, convincing for the most part in the end, and 5 points clear at the top of the National League South. How does that feel?
I'm delighted with the victory, first and foremost, because that's what football's about. It's about winning matches. I still think we can improve, manage games better. And we shouldn't really be having that nervy finish, you know. And that's my fault as well. I've made substitutions that probably have affected the game as well. So I look at myself first and foremost, but we can still improve. We can still manage games better. And we should have really put the game to bed in the second half. So I'm a little bit disappointed we lost the second half 1-0. But all in all, I'm just delighted with the victory.
I think we should touch on the first half because, bear in mind, I actually thought Maidstone probably started the better of the two teams for sort of the first 15-20 minutes. But then Clifford scores what is a freak goal. I doubt that he meant directly from a corner. And then I thought Wolverstone were in the driving seat throughout that half.
And we work on trying to score from corners, if I'm being honest, Deck. That's one of our corners. We've five or six. So it is one of our corners where we complete runs and get people across and we try to get a lot of pace on the ball. So I wouldn't say it was freak. So I think it was good quality, great delivery, pace on the ball. Makes them have to defend it. If they can't deal with it, that's up to them. But our second goal was a fantastic goal. You know, we were probably about 15, 20 passes. We went side to side. We sucked them out. We played off the front man. Mendy managed to get himself free in the pocket where we want him to be. And a great finish by the kids. So all in all, yeah, first half I thought we were good at times. I would have liked us to start a little bit better because I thought the first five, six, probably 10 minutes they were a little bit stronger than us. But they're hard working side. They make it difficult for you. Very experienced management team, and they're tough to play against. You know, the sun was out. You know, don't make the pitch slick. It makes the pitch dry, which will help them the way they play. So I thought first half, yeah, we deserved our lead. Of 2 goals, and I was delighted at half time.
Talk about it being sunny and not having a pitch slick. It certainly had the gods looking down on you there, a bit of a downpour at half time, and then sort of made the ground a little bit wetter. And we started the second half a lot better. Is it down to that at all, or do you think it was just the players coming out a lot quicker and sharper?
No, I just think the pitch, when it's slick, we can move the ball quicker, especially against a team that quite defensive minded. You know, I mean, they get a lot of bodies behind the ball. I know they tried to play second half with a midfield run or any kind of runner they could to go in behind our high line. I think we can move the ball quicker, which helps. You know what I mean? It don't allow the opposition to get right in your face because we've got a lot of technical players that can handle it. We created numerous chances in the second half. We probably played better second half, more creative, better chances. We never got the goal, which I've no issue with missing chances. Once you're creating them, you are going to score goals. But I have got issues when we concede the goal we conceded, which is very frustrating. And it made it nervy, but a good test of our character. Good test of our togetherness. I thought after they scored, they had no real chances, they had no real attempts on our goal. So we still had a good 8, 9 minutes to play after they scored. So, but just a bit disappointed with the goal, to be honest.
Mainly, what we're talking about here is that we probably weren't in fifth gear today, and yet we're playing a team that's tipped to be one of the favourites to go up this season from the division. That must be a pleasing thing for you to see.
I don't really care about them, if I'm being honest with you. I don't. Like, I look at our team, how we can manage, how can we make it 3, 4, 5. I don't mean that any disrespect to John or Hack, the top management team. Been there, done it, got the T-shirt. They can only manage their team the way they want. I'll manage my team the way I want. We need to do better. We can't have these nervy finishes. We can't be 3-1 up last week. It's 3-all, and then we have to win 4-3. Even though it was great for a character, great for a team building, our guts, which we showed again today. Really, what if they had one chance, second half? Is that right? And they took it. So that can't happen. That's not good enough. You know, we've had six, seven, you know what I mean, eight chances, and we should have run really by two, three clear goals. So we just got to make sure that happens. And I'm not trying to criticise anybody or anything like that, you know, or any of the players. We just set a high bar and they've got to reach it because if you want success, that's the level you've got to get to.
Of course, after the end of the first month of the season with 5 points clear, it's great to see, actually, to be fair, that you're able to pick these sort of criticisms out of your own team, because a lot of people that have come down here, the ordinary fan, will just say, "Oh, we're 5 points clear. We're doing great in the first 7, 8 games of the season." So that kind of shows how well you know your team as opposed to maybe outsiders.
Think to keep improving. You've got to keep raising the bar. You know what I mean? The standards we set ourselves, we've got to get better because teams are going to come here and try to figure out our weaknesses. We've got to figure out theirs. So we just always want to improve. And I've always been like that as a person, as a manager. And I think it's the same for the players. They want to improve as well. Like I said to you before, there's a lot of hungry players in this group. And I think that if they want to really make names for themselves again, you know what I mean, they've got to make sure that we raise the bar and we improve our performances. I know we're good to watch. I understand that. I get that. We've got a lot of speed, technically strong. But our game management, our sustaining of attacks has to be better. I think that's very important. And if we do that, the games will be more comfortable for us.
And now we look on to Tuesday. Of course, we're going to Clarence Park and facing St Albans City in our ninth game of the season. How do you look at that going in? Because obviously Ian's got a good team down there, and you know they're normally around sort of top seven sort of area. So how do you look at that going into it?
Ian's another manager. I've been there. Done. I got the T-shirt. Got Bournemouth promoted when he was manager there. Always in and around the top ten on a lower budget for the division. So he will be knocking on them places, no doubt. To be fair, they've got pace. So very similar to today's team, you know what I mean? What we've played against in Maidstone, they'll be very similar to that. They've got a poacher in the lad up front, the nine who leads the line for them. So I know a few of the players, I've managed a few of them, so there's no doubt. It's not an easy place to go on a Tuesday night, is it? So bit of a hill on the pitch. The pitch is usually excellent there, but we just look forward to it. Like I say, we enjoy this evening, which we will do. And then we'll just move on to Tuesday evening and make sure from tomorrow morning I'll be watching the videos and focused, and the players will know their jobs come Tuesday.
Thank you, Dean.
Cheers, Dave. Top man.